Jesse. We can't continue like this.
I told you, I already talked to the cops.
And I told you, I'm not a cop. I'm a police psychologist.
He is a psychologist. Hey, a priest!
All right, then. I'm a priest.
You better be. Because we're all going to need one. All right, then. Father, forgive me, for I have sinned. I have blasphemed. I have willed me allied Satan and desecrated the dead. Let's see. What else?
What about lying? Stealing? Murder?
I see you've been reading the police file on me. I keep telling you, morons, the body you found was not Dr. Strange's. I mean, the body was his, but that's not him.
Jesse, listen to what you're saying. Either you are mad, or you're pretending to be. And if you're not, you better prove to me that you're not by telling me the truth.
Mr. Moore, Dr. Strange once told me that there's no such thing as the truth. If no one believes you when you tell it, I'm begging you now. Damn it, please believe me. Believe me.
What went wrong, Jesse? What went wrong?
Hey, how did you get this graduation card anyway?
Well, I was chasing this young lady in the bar and twisted her going down to the depths. I was just trying to convince her that going back to her place and performing a mad passion or upload this year would not spoil her reputation as a
Let's make a toast to our friend Jesse, who's graduating and going on to become. What the hell are you gonna do now?
He's not even gonna go out and get laid. God knows I never saw him do anything the last 4 years but read books.
Hey, didn't you, like, want to be a horse doctor? Yeah, suing the suppositories and horses.
Oh, you're so gross.
Thank you very much.
All right. Allow me... For all your information, allow me to explain that I have received an invitation from my uncle to join him in his research work on back teeth. Hey, my uncle happens to be one of the finest biochemists in the business. And later on, I should say, when I am rich and famous, you'll all want to kiss the hand of my lab coach.
Dr. Strange.
Doctor? Why, Jesse, it's good to see you. I'm your uncle.
Oh, Dr. Strand, how are you?
I'm glad to see that you made it up here without much trouble. You see, when people find themselves lost around here, they get rather frightened.
Thank you, Dad.
Mm-hmm. Your place is very isolated.
Yes, it's perfect in that sense. It allows me to conduct my experiments in total privacy, away from the prying eyes of the local yokels. But how are your parents? They must be very proud of you graduating from school.
Yeah, they were. Although they probably thought it meant that I was moving back in with them again. Actually, they're moving their business back to Connecticut. After Dad took nearly 1 year negotiating a contract guaranteeing that the old business isn't broken into pieces once they sell it. You know, just in case anything funny happens to the market in the next few years.
You're a cautious one, Grandfather. Even as a little boy, he always alerted himself to the element of risk. But I, too, am very proud, Jesse. It was comforting to know that I wasn't the only one in our family who had a passion for science. But I have an even more selfish reason. I'm very glad that you came here as quickly as you did. I just wish it would have been under much better circumstances. Let me explain. You see, I've been conducting research on cellular rejuvenation, particularly that of brain cells. As you know, brain cells do not regenerate once they've died. And I've had extraordinary success in regenerating dead brain tissue and other body tissue as well, ranging from hearts, eyes, nervous systems, muscles, etc. But tragically, administered to live tissue, especially that of a human, the results, well, to put it mildly, were catastrophic.
But what happened when was it?
As you can see, it has a reverse effect. It seems that it creates an entirely different cell structure after it's destroyed the old one.
Why not wait for it to create a new cell structure for you?
Well, as you can see, the new structure is vastly different from the old one.
But wouldn't it improve it?
Not exactly.
I mean the...
I think I should show you something.
Yes.
Hiding in a factory when the police found him after killing a little girl. He fell into a vat of industrial acid and killed himself. But as you can see, I've been very successful in the reconstruction of his cellular structure. His form is quite functional, wouldn't you agree?
Yes, sir.
This is my pride and joy. But at the risk of sounding somewhat sanctimonious, he doesn't have what you would call a soul. That which separates man from beast.
A soul? Doctor,
I don't mean to be argumentative,
but as a scientist, I must believe the mind. The mind is a spirit. I mean, if he has a brain.
He have a brain. A brain of a new cellular structure. And consequently, his capacity for learning is far greater than yours or mine. In time, he could recite the poetry of Keats. But what would he know about beauty and love? In a short time, he could recite the scripture, backwards and forwards. But what would he learn about truth and goodness and good and evil? No. These are the concepts of the soul. Man is always trying to answer the unanswerable. This is not governed by the laws of science. Man's science is of no avail to us here. We must use God's science.
And in this room, this is where man's science ends. Even as a student, I knew that the mysteries of life did not begin and end in a test tube. The ancients believed in the harmony of science and the spirit. It's been said sometimes that alchemy is an abortive and lucrative attempt at chemistry. But nothing could be further from the truth. Alchemy is an ancient science. In remote times, man studied nature in its body, in its spirit, and in its life. By the study of its nature, it came into the formulation of the laws of universal organization. And the study of his spirit brought about the laws of transformation and the mutation of metals. And the study of his soul brought about the power of creation. And with this knowledge, I will attempt to turn these creatures into, for the want of a better phrase, spiritual being, and I pray help save myself in the process.
But how can that be possible?
With this, it's no coincidence that I conduct my experiments in a secluded and tranquil location. The previous owner was Alger Terhune, a powerful alchemist, well known in the supernatural community. When I found out that he was mysteriously dying from unusual causes, I patiently waited to legally attain the property, well aware of the fact that an invaluable reservoir of knowledge in the form of manuscripts is hidden somewhere within these walls. If the ancients can help me, I'll be able to transfer souls into the bodies of these creatures, thereby making it easy for me to transfer my own soul into one of these waiting bodies of these physically able creatures, so that I might find a way to stop the degeneration process in case my mental state suffers in the course of my cellular breakdown.
Even if such a thing were possible, where would you get these souls of which you spoke?
The same place where I originally got these bodies. There is a small cemetery nearby, where the neighboring town buries its more notorious criminals, away from their family cemetery. They call it the Field of the Damned. I will attempt to transfer a soul from a grave into one of these bodies. Trial run of sorts before transferring my own. Jesse, I know these things may have overwhelmed you, but you've got to believe enough into helping me. You're the only...
Doctor, are you okay?
Oh, God. It's progressing rapidly. I'm gonna have to start wearing gloves. Soon I'm gonna... be the cause of a million accidents in the lab. And then my hands will be useless altogether. Be my hands, Jesse. Here you'll see things you'll never see in any technical institute. You'll go far beyond the scope of any professor or any textbook. Please.
All right, Uncle. I'll help you.
Good. Good. The first thing we'll need is a blood sample in a cell culture from number two.
Doctor, you referred to him as number two. Am I to assume there was a number one?
Yes, it was. However, he escaped. And I haven't had the time, nor quite frankly, the inclination to search for him. But fortunately, I have you. Well, Jesse, seems there's a flicker of hope after all. Seems the regeneration process in number two has stopped. If that regeneration process has stopped,
there may be a way to reverse it.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Quickly, Jesse, bring number three into the lab. I want to check the treatments we've been giving him.
Yes, sir.
I want to see if the process has reversed itself.
There were things the doctor wasn't telling me. He tried to sound optimistic. I could sense the desperation in him. I knew it was leading him within darker places of his heart. And mine.
Relax now, Jesse. I've sedated him and put him in reinforced shackles. He shouldn't be able to escape again.
That's good, because I wouldn't have a surprise wake-up call. But as tired as I am, I doubt anything will wake me.
Yes, we've worked very hard today. Sleep well and save your energy, because we will need all of your strength tomorrow.
All right, Uncle. Good night.
Yes, good night.
Examination of the blood extraction number three. I discovered the formula I injected into number three proved less than successful. As soon as one cycle is complete, all the candles will extinguish in the circle.
Rudalo Prisha Masha Rudalo
What did I do wrong? Terhune, what did I do wrong?
Entry number 218. I've injected my subject with the ether formula. Life to death. Death to life. And now I must inject myself in order to complete the cycle. Thank you.
I survived.
Jesse, we have to perform the ritual again, and this time we'll get it right.
Detective Bryant tells me that three burnt corpses were found in shallow graves not far from the house.
Oh, God, don't you understand? It was not the screen of burning pictures. Now do you believe me?
Hey,
now do you believe me?
Fucker.